Some advice for improving your stitch is to take all the four corners, so this one, this one, this one, and this one, and to pull them all at once, and yeah, try, and it can give you some improvements. Anyway, we need to make a few more 2x4 before cutting the black strings and the white. So yeah, let's make them. As always, taking your try to order your strings. I'll take this string here, weaving. And pulling the strings, and I'll show you live how to take your four corners. It's kinda pulling a box stitch, actually. Take all your four corners and let's try to do it. Of course, these two will not give any I don't know. Let's do it again. Let's see if it makes any difference. And yeah, it kind of made it a little bit better. Yeah, good way. See, it's kind of good. And of course, another one. So we are. We made 1, 2, 3. I think. And here we are in 1, 2, 3. Need to make, I think, another two B4s. And I'm considering to cut the white strings. So I think the white string here can say goodbye because we don't need it anymore. It's already stuck inside the stitches. And the only white string is here, and at the end of the day we're going to glue here and here, so it doesn't really matter for us anymore. The other black strings is not that good idea to cut them, because we need to make sure that the mouth will always stay the same. It won't get outside. So the more you keep the black strings, the more you have friction, and then the more it'll the more harder that this mouth will get loosened. If that makes sense for you. Another advice is to glue the white strings, but I'm not going to do it because sometimes when you glue can cause problems. That's the idea. So the minimum of glue, the better situation you'll have. And never to before. It's our life here. Maybe even to move this here. I don't know. I'll do it as always, keeping the same positions. At least at most times. And take next yellow. Again, let's do the same trick with all the corners. And let's see if it will make a difference. I tighten it very strongly as possible, and you can see always the this loop and this loop is always not reacting, but you can always fix that. And let's see over here. Oh no, it's ugly. See, this thing is ugly. This thing that you don't want to have. So it always good. Has been a while. See, I fixed it like that. Not that good as well. Terrible. So the thing here is, you see, this loop is okay, so we can maybe even force it a little bit more and do the same thing here, the other side. And next, we can try to space it evenly. Now, I think it's a good idea to move the strings, because you see, three strings here at the center, and that makes a little bad here, and yeah, this is the problem. So I'm gonna change here, one here, just one. And let's see if it makes a difference. So one here, and of course you want to make it symmetrical, so do it also here. Well, we don't have a choice with these three strings, so good idea also to turn a little bit of strings. Maybe it can help. And what's more, that's what you can do. And if that doesn't help, then maybe even try to pull a little bit more. And once you get this loop here is starting to get a little bit crooked, so pull the loop. So this loop here comes here and over here, so stretch the loop. That makes it a little bit better. See, the more you the more you, how is it? I can't find my word. The more you fix the stitch, the more you spend time on every stitch to perfect it, the better your Pikachu will be. So do it's I'm trying it intentionally because I want to show you that if you don't do that, things can get very ugly. And that's I don't want you to have. Okay, so moving on. And we need to make see when 1, 2, 3, 4 and here have 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to finish all this part with one last 2x4 and that'll be it I think for this part. So I'm going to do it a little bit faster because you got the idea. I'll do my trick, all these four strings directly inside the loop. Later on, I'll sort everything so all the black strings will stay in place. Now, I do it one here. One is here. Finally, taking the strings that are on needs to get under for our last string to weave. It is on the right side here. And it's kind of long, so pulling it through like a thread. And pulling the stitch. Next, we're going to finish off the eyes. So first of all, I suggest first of all to cut the strings and then glue it. So yeah, have your glue, your new glue, and yeah, make sure it's new and it's super glue, of course, for plastic. And I'll give links for my glue if you want to buy it. I'll add links down below. And you want to glue here and glue here. And before we want to cut very, very gently with drinks. Because problem is that if you first glue and then cut the strings, it's not going to look as nice as these eyes. Because you'll end up with some string here. So what you want to do is to cut the strings and then push them a tiny little bit, and then you'll get a square, not like a stitch that has like a string here, a string here, a string here, and a string here. So just follow my orders and it'll be, hopefully it'll be fine. You need to make it very, very gently because it can be a little bit unsafe. So make sure you cut the strings and don't make mistakes by, I don't know, cutting some other things on the way. Okay, so make sure you cut like that. And you even want to cut a little bit more. So find the string. Of course, excuse me, but the string are blacks, black strings. It's hard to see, but hopefully you'll see the white strings, how they'll be done. White is easier to see. Okay, make sure you grab the edge of a string. Okay, that's pretty great. So do the same thing for the other three sides. So that's not the ideal. You see, if I first glue and then I cut, you'll get something like that, and then you can't cut anymore because if you cut any a little bit more, then the glue will come off. Like you'll scratch the glue, and then it's not going to have the same effect as this one. So let's continue cutting the string. Again, very gently because any little mistake can. It's not going to be my fault if it'll break. You have to be very gently about it. About it. Okay, that's, I think, is an okay option. Maybe a little bit more, I don't know. Think a little bit more, and then you continue to the second, to the third black. Another suggestion is to just scratch a string, and then it can come off a little bit more. Like that, see? It's a good idea. See, now it's a little bit better. And the last black string, and then I continue off with the white, and you will see exactly how it's done, because the white is easier to see. Again, even if you pull the string, if you cut the string, this might be this or this one might come off. So be very gently about it. Think it's. We'll see it again a little bit more because. Well, actually, I think it's good. So almost finished. Now the white string, and here you'll see it better how it will be done. So you see, that's not the complete thing here. One last time to cut it. Now comes a very important part. You have to watch it. What I'll do now is I'm going to push the edges of the strings so it'll be 100% square. I said earlier that now you can see that the strings here are a little bit pointy. And if I glued the stitch first and then cut the strings, then I can't pull them. I can't push them here. Squeeze it here. Because the stitch is glued. And you can't. That's it. If once you glue a stitch, you can't fix it or something. So first, cut the strings like I did here. Now you can push them a little bit. So you can see. Push it very, very gently, of course. Be as gentle as possible because any little mistake can be hard to fix. What you can do also is to squeeze it with your hands, but I'm not going to do it because you won't see what I'm doing. So I'm doing with scissors. And do exactly what I'm doing here, that's the correct way. Okay, now it's almost easy to see that I'm just pulling here with a white string and the back string here. And do it like it's like a clay. You do like I don't know clay or something. When you just push it a little bit, squeeze it sometimes. I'm speaking rubbish, but anyway, that's what I'm doing. Almost done. I think that's almost as good as this one. So maybe this black string and the white is not that good. So I'll try to push them a little bit more. See now that's it. This is great. Now a white string here is great. One last time with this black. It's better to do it very slowly instead of doing fast and then it's gonna break. So it's better to show you 10 minutes how to do it instead of just skipping here because I'm sure that some of you might want to see the whole part of it. Again, you can try to scratch it a little bit so it'll come off. But think that's it. Okay, that's a complete thing. See, it's almost as this one, except from here maybe. So again, one last time. Okay, now you can finish off. So what I'll do is, one second, I'll just try to scratch the edgy part here. Okay, now it's good. And finally, we need just to glue it. So do again, glue it very, very slowly. Don't make a huge drop. So find a good amount of glue to add. Okay, that's enough. And now I'll just leave it to dry. Next, we're going to do the right eye, and going to do it more rapidly because I think you got the idea on the left eye. So again, make sure the glue is dried. Okay, and we're going to continue with the right eye and cutting the first black string. Yeah, make sure the stitch is stretched and all, you know. Stretch it one last time, even if you want. And I'll cut the strings. Try to cut as much as you can. Now, this black string. That's enough of this. Last black string, hopefully it will come out well. Okay, that's good. Again, that's the maximum I could do. And the last white. Okay, that's good, and glue, and we're all done with part number three. I'll give it to rest. Give it some minutes to rest, and I'll finish up this part. So, yep, see you next time. Next time, hopefully, we'll get to the end of a body, maybe even the legs, and then things go gonna be a little bit more interesting. We're also going to add, I think, cheeks. The cheeks here will be here. Until next time, bye bye.